What's going on, guys? It's Space from the Yeti Brigade. Colonel Young on the camera over there. Today we have the TPX pistol, fully loaded with everything. Unfortunately, we don't have any 12 gram cartridges, but we have it hooked up to a 6845. We only have two clips, and we're gonna fire off a few rounds and then bring it in for a conclusion. All right. Let's see. I'm gonna have to hold the bottle. Forgive me. Let's see how accurate it is. I'm gonna shoot it at our marking frame that's covered in paint. Man, 7 rounds goes quick, man. 7 rounds go quick. Alright, fire the 7. Out. All right, we're gonna have a gun mounted view, and yeah, take a look. That's it.
What's going on, guys? Based from the Yeti Brigade, my man.
Colonel Young.
Yep. We have the TIPX from Tippmann. It's a mag-fed pistol, and what can we say about it, man? This thing shot pretty damn straight at 60 feet. You saw it in the videos. It shot really, really well. A few gripes, though. Let's get into the negatives before anything else. The handle is crazy thick. You need gigantic hands to wield this comfortably. If you have a glove on, it'll probably make it even worse. But even though it's thick, it has a very hefty feel to it. We're outside, my mother's front yard, in her house out in Long Island. So don't mind the noise. All right. Another thing that's really cool is the ability to go, you know, remote mine instead of
12 grams.
But you need one of these in order to
keep it pressurized.
Yep. So, yeah, what can we say, man? As I say, shot
straight. Also, what do you call it? If you look at where the magazine release is, it's somewhere right over here. It's kind of annoying to, you know, in the middle of like a firefight, it's kind of annoying to take out and reload. You know, you would prefer something like up here, but you gotta reach in, and if you got small hands, it's definitely even harder.
Yeah. Great thing is, it has rails on the bottom, so you could have a camera mounted on there. As you saw, we mounted the contour to the bottom rails over here, and it was pretty damn excellent. It was pretty damn excellent. It doesn't increase the profile at all.
It's fun to
shoot.
It's very fun to shoot.
Mm-hmm.
Even though you're limited to 7 rounds.
7 rounds, exactly. Another great feature is that it shows you when you're running out with these clear windows over here and window on the top. If you see this thing is covered with paint, you know you had a chop. And doing maintenance on this thing to clean it kind of sucks, because you have to open it up and everything's all spring pressurized and things would pop out and whatnot. But this thing shoots pretty damn good. We weren't rapid firing it, and I don't know how it would be if we did rapid fire.
You'd probably be out in a second.
Yeah. This is 7 rounds, you know, you go through it so fast, it's ridiculous, especially in paintball.
You gotta make sure you count those rounds, because I was counting it on like on the 8th round, I forgot, and you know,
dry fired
a couple times.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's a pretty sturdy and solid gun, or pistol. It has its disadvantages, you know, limited magazine capacity. The magazine release is kind of funky.
Mm-hmm. It's thick.
Yeah, it has a thick.
Oh yeah.
It has a thick magazine. Mm-hmm. I mean pistol mag, pistol grip. Mm-hmm. Some people don't like this, the grooves over here, so they tend to shave it off to make it straight.
It wouldn't be a bad idea to shave it off.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, the magazine is definitely smaller than the Tiberius 8.1, which requires you to have a 12 gram in each one of them. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that's a plus. I actually like this design over the Tiberius. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I mean, it's fun to shoot with. If you like pistols, if you like dual pistols, you know, this wouldn't be a bad choice. Again, it's a really short barrel. So, you know, you gotta really make your shots count. And you also shouldn't be shooting in a range excess of like 40 feet. You know, I mean, that's not good for this thing.
It could do well at 60 feet. But anything more than that, you're really pushing it. It's not, yeah. I don't think it's meant to, but I think this is meant for up close and personal kind of engagements, execution style shots, whatever, you know?
Yep.
I like it. I gotta pick myself up one.
Not really sure why they added this little nub here. I guess it's for like a sling of some sort, mm-hmm. but it just seems like it'll get in the way. But yeah, it's nice. It's nice and sturdy. You can beat up something with it.
Yeah, pistol whip somebody real nice, right?
Yeah.
Alright.
If you run out of paintballs, you know?
Mm-hmm. This thing is it's a sidearm. It's not going to be anybody's primary. There's some people that are very exceptional with MagFed.
Yeah.
But I don't imagine this being somebody's primary, a lot of people's primary, that is. So I guess that's it for the TPX. We like it. You know, I wish the magazine, the handle was a little thinner. But aside from that, it's great. It's a great sidearm, and I gotta pick myself up one. Concluding thoughts on it?
No, that's it. We covered everything. I mean, it shoots well, you know, decent size, and yeah, good design.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
You have to be gate out.
Over.
Mm-hmm.